Hey guys, welcome back to our milk bread recipe experiment series. Last time we compared sort of general recipes that one uses yurine and one uses the tongdong method, and that just gave us a good taste of how milk bread is made and what sort of the recipe might entail. But it wasn't a really good direct comparison between the two methods. Today we are going to use a direct comparison, but first you might be wondering, you know, if milk bread doesn't technically require a starter, why would we use one, right? So a normal bread loaf will have something like a 60% hydration. Using a starter allows us to up the hydration in the loaf, and that allows us to basically have a much more moist bread. So if you imagine using either the yurine or tongdong technique, you can increase the hydration to almost 80%. That higher hydration is going to allow us to basically steam the bread as it bakes, which allows it to fluff up, rise, get really moist. And also that moisture helps with the shelf life, which is kind of the theory behind why people created this starter. Was really to give this white bread or sandwich bread a much better shelf life. The yurine uses about a 1-to-1 ratio between flour and water, whereas the tongdong is more of like a 1-to-5, so a lot more liquid. In our first episode, we did notice that Umi's tongdong recipe did come out a little bit more moist, in that the texture kind of melted in your mouth and it was a little bit more gummy. Even though I know the word gummy might not be like appealing, so it might not be the right descriptor, but less of a chew and more of like a fall apart in your mouth. So of course those were totally different recipes, so we can't really say for sure if the technique was what made it that way. So today we're gonna borrow from Princess Bamboo, another very popular YouTube channel, and she did this experiment, and she already created this recipe for the exact same loaf, but adjusted per the method. So we're gonna go ahead and test out her recipes and see for ourselves if yurine or tongdong makes a big difference, or if we have a preference to either method. All right, let's get to the kitchen. To make milk bread, you'll need bread flour, water, whole milk, sugar, salt, dry yeast, and unsalted butter. First, we'll go over how to make the tongdong starter. In a small saucepan, mix 20 grams of bread flour, 50 milliliters of water, and 50 milliliters of whole milk. Give that a mix until it's well incorporated, and then turn on the heat to about medium or medium high. You're gonna cook this slurry until it thickens and becomes a really smooth paste. Then remove it from the pan and set it aside to cool. You can also make this the night before baking and then put it in the fridge and then bring it back to room temp before using. Next, we'll go over how to make the yurine starter. Just take 75 grams of bread flour and 125 milliliters of boiling water and mix the two together until well combined. Then set aside and allow it to cool. All right, for the main part of the recipe, you can start by just greasing your loaf pan and setting that to the side. Then in a stand mixer, we're gonna mix all the dries. The rest of your bread flour, 30 grams of sugar, 7 grams of salt, 6 grams of dry yeast, and just give that a quick stir with your dough hook. Then you're gonna add your liquids. Slowly pour in your water and your whole milk and mix until all the dough starts to come together, about 5 minutes on speed 6. Then you're gonna add either your yurine or tongdong and mix another 5 minutes until the dough comes together again. Finally, you're gonna add your butter and then mix another 3 minutes until fully incorporated. The dough should look smooth and should pass your window pane stretch test. At this point, it's ready to go, so we'll remove it from the stand mixer and place it on our workstation so that we can shape it into a bowl. This time, our dough turned out a little bit wetter than we're used to, but that's okay. You can just use a bench scraper and do your best to shape it. If it's really too wet to handle, you can mix it for longer to create more gluten. Place your shaped bowl into an oiled bowl and cover it to rest for 45 to an hour. Once it's doubled in size, use the finger test to see if it's ready. If it is, then go ahead and punch it down, give it some fresh oxygen, and then scrape the dough out of the bowl and onto your workstation. Then split your dough into two equal pieces, and then reshape those two pieces into bowls once more. If it's still too wet, go ahead and just tuck it into itself, and that's a little bit easier.
Once shaped, place them back into the bowl and cover for a quick rest of 10 minutes. When that's ready, we're going to shape the pieces for the actual loaf. We're going to flatten out the bowls, fold them into thirds, and then roll it up perpendicular to those first folds. Don't worry if they don't look super perfect, your bread will still taste great. But the smoother you can get the dough, then the smoother the final loaf will look. Load up your loaf pan, then cover for 45 minutes. Optional egg wash, and then bake at 190 degrees Celsius for 35 to 40 minutes.
Okay, so that was a little bit interesting. And I say that because our initial test run of these recipes turned out quite different. I think it might be because today is rainy and that's thrown off like our our dough recipes. And I confess that, you know, this is like our first foray into baking. And so don't know enough to like how to adjust. But those breads, the doughs, rather, came out a lot wetter than I remembered them from the test run. But it kind of created this like really interesting, more of like a crisp crust, a little bit like a French loaf, which is not what we're going for in milk bread, but it was kind of like an interesting accident. Unfortunately, I don't think those recipes like quite matched the originals, but I still think they give us a good direct comparison since it's still the same recipe, adjusted per the methods. So we did notice that this recipe, Princess Bamboo's recipes, give us a little bit more of a fluffy loaf, like in that it's a lot spongier and you can see like much bigger air pockets, which is really nice. And the only real significant difference that we could find between the two methods was that the Yudane had a little bit more of like a tang, like just the slightest hint of like a little bit of a sour to it, whereas the Tangzong had a more like mild, just fragrant, you know, like an aromatic bread smell flavor. So there wasn't too much of a difference other than that. So I think, you know, we're still a little bit in a place where we can't determine whether one method is better than the other. There aren't strong differences, so at this point, I think we would just conclude that having a starter definitely gives us pretty fluffy, moist bread, and one is not necessarily better than the other, and it seems a little bit more convenience or preference at this point. So I think we still need to test a couple more recipes. So next time we will test whether using a starter makes a difference at all, so should we even bother? A little bit backwards, I know, but we will test one recipe that uses tongzong and then one that doesn't use a starter at all, and then maybe we can land on a favorite recipe and we can compare which one is the best, at least for our personal preference. Of course, it may differ for you, and hopefully all of these little notes that we're trying to take while we're tasting and testing these recipes will help you determine which one is best for you. All right, thanks. If you guys enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs like, subscribe, hit the bell, all those good things. Join us on Scene if you guys want to talk more bread and other favorite things, or have questions, or you have answers even to our questions. That would super help us out, and we would love for you to be part of our community. All right, guys, we'll see you in the next one. Bye.